Special service today as we remember and celebrate the life of Nathan Watt. Would you please stand together and let's open with the hymn that insert in your bulletin on Eagle's Wing.
Amen.
On behalf of Nathan's family, I want to thank you for coming to this service as we celebrate Nathan's life. We're giving thanks to God for this dear father, brother, uncle, and papa. For all who are gathered here today, he was a very dear friend. So following the service, there will be that will go for the burial, and then there'll be a time of food and fellowship at Hiddenwood. So please join the family for this time. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we're grateful today that you're the God of all comfort. And we welcome your presence as we worship you, as we give thanks to you, Lord, for the gift of Nathan Walk to our lives. Father God, we trust you for heaven's touch upon each heart as we've gathered here today. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. This time, I'd ask Pastor Aaron Dillon if she'd come and share with me some scripture for us.
So that where I am, you will be also. You know the way where I am going. Lord, Thomas says, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus tells him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Amen.
Go to heaven and shout.
come share the obituary with us.
Good morning. Nathan Joel Walt was born on August 31st, 1979, the son of Lydell and Wendy Ike Walt of Minot, North Dakota. He was raised on the Walt family farm near Ryder, North Dakota, and graduated from North Shore High School in 1997. He furthered his education by attending Wyoming Tech, where he graduated with a degree in auto body repair. Following his graduation, he returned to Minot and he began working at Prairie Truck Equipment. He worked a variety of blue-collar jobs, such as diesel mechanic, construction, and oil field work. He was once married to Delray Hofer, and to this union, four daughters were born, Lainey, Naya, Jada, and Jetta. The couple later divorced. In 2013, Nathan was a recipient of a kidney transplant from his cousin, Holly DeWitts. From this gift, he was able to enjoy life to the fullest for 6 years before his disease returned. Nathan had many health concerns during his adult life due to battling this kidney disease. On September 26, 2020, Nathan was united in marriage to Nicole Bennett at Hiddenwood Lake. They made their home near Ryder, North Dakota, with Nathan's four daughters and Nicole's four children, Keegan, Layla, Olivia, and Sibeli. Family was the most important thing to Nathan. His children remember going for rides in different trucks or project cars with their dad and singing all their favorite songs. Their favorite phrase was "drop the hammer" when it was really time to step on it. Nathan and his family spent many years camping, boating, and fishing at different spots around North Dakota. He enjoyed hunting with family and friends, and he especially loved taking his children and nephews out to look for pheasant, deer, or coyotes. Nathan was always down for a race, and he drove many race cars, real and makeshift, throughout the years. He participated in races, pickup poles, and mud runs, and Nathan always had more projects than time, tinkering on four-wheelers, motorcycles, cars, trucks, and even golf carts. He spoke highly of his time under the hood with his father, Lydell. Now, I'm sure he's got some of those projects left, girls, so maybe you girls can go out there and tackle a few things, put pieces back together. But those who shared in his life, his wife Nicole, children Lainey and Austin, Naya, Jada, and Jetta, one grandson, Sawyer, parents Lydell and Wendy, his mother-in-law, Sherry Bennett, two sisters, Heather and Sean Kluber, Schoenberg, and Heidi and Brian Walsh, nieces and nephews, Alex, Matthew, Lucas, Dalton, and Tristan, maternal grandmother, Mabel Ike, stepchildren, Tegan, Layla, Olivia, Savely, and his beloved chocolate lab named Lip. Why did he call him Lip? Anybody got any answer to that? Nathan was preceded in death by his grandparents, Lloyd Ike, Henry, and Evelyn Walk, and Nicole's grandparents, Harvey and Julia Bennett, cousin Troy Walk, aunts and uncles, Wayne Rouse, Marilyn Walk, Diane Walk, and Joey and Gail Patterson, and his beloved husky, Snoop. May God bless the memory of Nathan Joel Walk.
There's so many things we can share. We had a time last night there in Minot sharing some of the memories, but not all of them got into that. So I have a few more that I'd like to share with us today. His daughter Naya said that Nathan won first place at the races, and she got to ride with him for the victory lap, and that they both got to wave out the windows. And there was also a go-kart that he tried to rev it up a bit and make it go turbo, as he liked to call it. But when they tried out his new invention, it started on fire. Stuff happens, doesn't it? And then from his sisters, Heather and Heidi, they wrote this up for us. He said, "We were blessed to grow up close to family. We'd celebrate every holiday together and milestones together as a family. Aunts and uncles were considered also grandma and grandpas to us. And as we got older, our cousin kids even called Nathan Uncle Nathan. The summer months were all about camping with the family. The days consisted of floating on inner tubes, getting pulled on inner tubes, and fishing from sunup to sundown. And then it was campfire time. The boys' theory was that if you could not see the campfire from outer space, then it was not a campfire or a special occasion. There might be a flaming marshmallow. On the 4th of July week, we also were blessed to have families that lived on our gravel road join us, along with all of our family members. The summers always ended up with camping in the Badlands. We hiked the same trails and climbed the same mountains every year, and it never got old. Nathan always got to bring a friend because it was his birthday, around his birthday. And one night our parents put up a tent and let us girls stay in it. And Nathan was so mad. Him and his friend slept on the lawn chair that night while a herd of buffaloes decided to run through the campgrounds. All of us kids woke up at the campground from screaming. The stories are so endless, and we always had a blast. As he became that uncle, he took all his nephews hunting and fishing if he wasn't feeling good. He even taught his husky dog Snoop to pheasant hunt. Mia would point the pheasant and Snoop would retrieve the birds and bring them back. There are hours of memories that we remember and that we laugh about. This is a day. This is a day to share that. So, stepdaughter Layla wrote this. September 26th of 2020, this date marks the union of Nathan Walk to Nicole Bennett, and with this union formed an albeit large blended family. With a family so large, packed in a house with so little rooms and space, we came across obstacles, we come across hardships, and maybe some that we won't ever be able to overcome. But with this union, Nathan gave us a promise, one for all of us to remember. Although Nathan promised us and didn't promise us lots of things, this one promise falls into the category of what he did and what he fulfilled. He promised to teach us stick shift, to keep the love for old, beaten, square bodies alive. He promised to take us to Hiddenwood Lake on sunny days to go fishing and to live in a quiet atmosphere that surrounded the refuge despite our more than chaotic lifestyle. He promised to see all of us graduate, even get married, to see us grow into adults. And despite the promises he can no longer fulfill, despite what we can no longer do with him, what he can no longer see, Nathan gave all of us the promise of a home, of a dad to love and look after us, a best friend to have fun with, a guardian to keep us all safe. And with such little time he had, he did all of that for all of us. Everyone in this room today, Nathan made the same silent promise. The promise is what made him a dad, a best friend, a guardian, and so, so much more. And despite the hardships, the cries, and the sorrow, we'll race on in his name, because Nathan is the best dad we could have ever had. Thank you, love. Nicole shares this with us. I have no idea what to say. I do know that it would be impossible to squeeze so many memories into such a short time. I already miss you so much. And all of these memories continue to make me smile, even on the toughest days. There are a few things that I believe will stick with me for the rest of my life. First of all, I always want to grab you candy at the gas station, sweet tarts, Twizzlers, and or runs. I found empty wrappers of them everywhere, or the occasional castaway banana run. Driving all around the country will forever make me think of you. You'll always take a different path everywhere we went. Some of those prairie roads nearly threw a person out of the cab of the pickup. I don't think I've spent as much time stalled on a dirt road as anyone else. Living with 10 people in one house is incredibly challenging, but when they play Just Dance On in Nintendo Wii, it can be quite entertaining. I have the videos to prove it. Blinkers, windshield wipers, and even heat or air conditioning are not necessary in your vehicle. I know the last few years have been so very tough. It always seemed like you were fighting a losing battle with your kidney disease. Watching you slip away more and more each day was excruciating. I want to thank you for teaching me how to ride a motorcycle, and there is a hack for every occasion. You also taught me patience, perseverance, and that my horrible sense of humor could be matched. I find comfort in knowing that you are finally at peace and able to be around those who love you without pain. Thank you. Thank you for those memories. And I want to encourage you today, as we have time for fellowship out of Hiddenwood, please share those memories with one another and also with the family. That's part of the way that God helps us in these places to heal together. The song that was requested to be sung is On the Wings of a Snow White Dove. I'd like to show it before I share the message this morning.
In various ways. sent down his love.
Thankful for his help. And then Jesus said this, and this is Well, if this doesn't speak to us where we are today, and in these days, Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy broken or heavy laden," or we can say this, "Come to me, all you who are heartbroken, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me." And Jesus said, "You will find rest." It's as we come to him with broken hearts, with sad hearts, he says, "I'll give you rest. I'll give you my comfort. I will be with you." And then Jesus spoke these words to his disciples and to us in John 14. We've heard them many times in services like this, but they're very powerful for us today. Jesus said this, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also." Thomas said to him, "Jesus, how can we know the way?" Jesus answered the question we all want the answer for, on how to know the way to heaven, and then how to have heaven in our hearts when we are broken and when we are heavy laden. You remember how Jesus taught us to pray? He said to pray for God's will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. Heaven isn't just a place that we go when we die. It's God with us here. Jesus said this. He said, "I am the way." Luke wrote in the book of Acts from Peter's message, he said, "Nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved." So I know we have many different church people from different denominations here, but Jesus said, and even if you don't have a church family or a church home, he says, "I'm the way for you, for all of us. There's not two ways, there's one way, and it's him." Those who have gone to heaven would tell us who are still here, heaven is real. Be ready for it. We weren't ready for Nathan to leave so quickly. We aren't ready for many of the things that happen. But what did Jesus say? He says, "I've gone to prepare for you." And when we look to him, he'll help us prepare. We're reminded today that life is a vapor with no guarantee of tomorrow. But we have a guarantee of eternity. Eternal life's guarantee in Jesus is called a blessed hope. What matters most in life isn't what we have, but it is our relationship with Christ Jesus. So we must give our lives to him. It's so simple, but we can get so busy. You know, it cost Jesus his life. So today's an excellent time for us to do a spiritual checkup and ask ourselves, am I ready to go to heaven? Have I been neglecting my spiritual health in relationship with Jesus? Would you bow your hearts with me and let's pray. Lord Jesus, we need you. We need your help. We need your comfort. We need the salvation that you paid your life for us to have. So Lord, thank you for knocking on the door of our hearts today, and all we have to do is open that door and say, "Jesus, come in. Forgive me of my sins. Give me this new life. Give me your help and your presence today. Thank you for making me new so that I can have the assurance of heaven. And Lord, with your help, from this day forward, I will live my life for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen." Would you join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Praise God. Well, we will leave from here, and we'll go up to the cemetery for the grave site. But you're invited to come out and join the family for food and fellowship at Hiddenwood. So, receive the benediction today. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to smile upon you and give you His peace. Let the treasure of special memories of Nathan bless your hearts today. Let the greatest treasure found in Christ Jesus, our Lord, fill our hearts with heaven's peace. And let the spirit of comfort surround us with heaven's comfort and grace. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Let's all stand together and let's sing our closing hymn that's in your bulletin, Amazing Grace.
Shall possess within. Praise God, praise God, praise God.